In this module, we will study the details of electrocardiogram. Our heart is actually a muscle, and as it pumps, each beat of the heart is set in motion by electrical signals from within the heart muscles. And the electrical activity of the heart is recorded by electrocardiogram, which is also known as ECG or EKG. Now we will see various steps in order to explain the electrocardiogram or ECG. You can see here the heart, and we can see the electrical signals being generated in the heart, and there is electrical conduction system, and of course, as we can see, that the electrocardiogram is showing the activity of the heart electrical conduction. So to start with, when your heart right atrium is filled with blood, the electrical signals spread across the cells of your heart right and left atria, and this signal causes the atria to contract or squeeze, and this pumps blood through the open walls from the atria into the both ventricles, and the P wave on the ECG make the contraction of your heart atria. And when the signals arrive at the atrioventricular node near the ventricles, it is slowed down for an instant to allow your heart right and left ventricles to fill with blood. And on an EKG, this interval is represented by the start of the line segment between the P and Q wave. The signal is released and moves next to the bundle of His, which is located in the heart's ventricles. And from the bundle of His, the signal fibers divide into left and right branches, which run through your heart septum. And on EKG, this is represented by the Q wave. And then the signal leaves the left and right bundle branches through the Purkinje fibers that connect directly to the cells in the wall of your heart's ventricles. The signal spreads quickly across your heart's ventricle. You can see here. And as the signal spread across the cells of the ventricle wall, both ventricle contract, but not at exactly the same moment, and the left ventricle of your heart contract an instant before the right ventricle. On an EKG, the R wave makes the contraction of your heart's left ventricle. You can see here. And the S wave actually makes the contraction of your heart's right ventricle. So the contraction of your heart's right ventricle pushes blood through the pulmonary valve to the lungs, and the contraction of your heart's left ventricle pushes blood through the aortic wall to the rest of your body. And as the signal passes, the walls of your heart ventricle relax and await the next signal. On the EKG, the T wave makes the point at which your heart's ventricle relaxing, and this process continues over and over again.